scanning electron. Scanning electron microscopes can give a 3D image of an object, like this picture of a Streptococcus bacterial strain. So you can see they really look very spherical here. It sort of, you know, like I said, it turns into more of a 3D image. But with the scanning electron, still you're only really seeing the surface. Tunneling electron microscopes can see things that are very small, including viruses. This is a picture of the HIV virus, which is 180 billionths of a meter across. That is extraordinarily tiny. So all of these electron microscopes, again, are super expensive, and you'll be lucky if you ever get to use one or even see one. Again, big universities and research facilities have them, but on, you know, your normal lab is not going to. So microscopes have come quite a long way. We even have microscopes that can see atoms in a substance, which is really small, and it's pretty amazing. But the most important part is how useful they are to the field of microbiology and the study of bacterial diseases, at least for us. By looking at samples of bacteria from a sick person, we can help narrow down and sometimes even diagnose the exact disease that the person is suffering from. So the real question is, what exactly do we look for when looking in a microscope? There are five basic things that we look for when looking at a specimen under the microscope. One, what kind of specimen is it? Is it a body fluid? Is it someone's sputum? Is it a stool specimen? What are we looking at? Number two, what shape are the bacteria? Do they look like circles? Do they look like rods? Do they look like spirals? Three, what size are the bacteria? Are they big? Are they small? Are they boxy? Are they thin? Four, what configuration are the bacteria in? Do they group together in any particular way? Do they stand in pairs, or do they like to have several that seem almost attached? And five, are they gram-positive or gram-negative? Today we're going to investigate shape and configuration. During the rest of the course, we'll touch upon these again and again and go further in depth with the type of specimen, size, and gram-positive or gram-negative. So you don't need to worry about what those are today. Just focus on shape and configuration. There are three main shapes that bacteria come in: circles, rods, and spirals. Now, of course, they're not named that way. We always have to have a special sciencey name for everything. Bacteria that are shaped like circles or spheres are called cocci. And you can see a picture of them here. All the little purple circles are all cocci. That's their shape. The bacteria that cause strep throat, staph infections, gonorrhea, scarlet fever, and necrotizing fasciitis are all cocci. Remember, this term refers to the shape. It doesn't mean that the same bacterial species cause all of these diseases, just that all those bacteria look like little circles. Bacilli. Bacteria that are shaped like rods are called bacilli, and you can see them here. They're a little bit longer, like rods. The bacteria that cause anthrax, botulism, leprosy, the plague, salmonella, tetanus, and a lot of other nasty diseases are all rod-shaped. They're all bacilli. Bacteria that are spiral-shaped are called sporilla, and you can see some here. They look like little worms. Most pathogenic bacteria are not sporilla. Really, the only ones that we're going to look at is the bacteria that causes Lyme disease and the bacteria that causes syphilis. So if you see bacteria that's spiral-shaped, that can really narrow it down as far as your options go. But in this class, we're mostly going to be talking about rods, bacilli, and cocci, because, again, most pathogenic bacteria are not sporilla. Again, for the most part, you're going to be looking at cocci and bacilli. The thing about bacilli and cocci is that they're not always that easy to tell apart. For example, what are the purple bacteria you see in the next slide? Think about it. What do they look like to you? Are they cocci? Are they bacilli? Are they short bacilli? Are they just funky-shaped cocci? They might be really small rods, right? And they're not perfectly circular, so you might not guess cocci. Well, in fact, these are cocci, but they're hanging out in pairs, which is why they sort of look funky. So as you see, the configuration of the bacteria makes a difference. These type of bacteria we usually refer to as diplococci. The prefix di means two, so diplococci are two cocci hanging out together. So basically just a pair of cocci just hanging out. In fact, if you see two bacilli hanging out together, you can add the same prefix and make it diplobacilli. But in general, though, bacilli like to hang out by themselves, so you really have to worry about their configuration. It's more the configuration of cocci that we have to think about. So that makes things a little easier. If you see bacteria that seem to be paired up or hanging out together, most likely they're going to be cocci. And we've already covered diplococci, but there are other configurations. The staph bacteria usually like to hang out in bunches we call staphylococci. They end up looking like a bunch of grapes. So when a scientist is trying to diagnose a disease, they can look to see if the cocci are in bunches and then hypothesize that they may be looking at staph bacteria. Now, just because I see this in a Gram stain in a slide doesn't mean I can definitely say, hey, you have a staph infection, but it's another hint to get us closer to a diagnosis. The strep bacteria, that is the one that causes strep throat, it likes to form chains of cocci. So sometimes we call that streptococci. And this also helps scientists diagnose strep diseases. But, you know, if I looked at this and I saw these long chains, I wouldn't be like, yes, it's definitely strep. I would say, well, I think it might be strep, and we have to do more tests to make sure. So just to summarize, the shapes are cocci, which is spherical, bacilli, which are rods, and spirilla, which are spirals. And then our configurations can be diplo, which is just two side by side, diplococci, although we can have diplobacilli, staphylococci, and streptococci. Staphylo would be in bunches, strepto is in chains. Those are always cocci, staphylococci, streptococci. There's not staphylobacilli. And there's not streptobacilli, okay? That just doesn't happen. That really only relates to cocci. So, just to summarize everything here, basically scientists use light microscopes. They can view the bacteria using the 100x ocular lens, which is often oil immersion, so the total magnification is 1000x. To identify the bacteria, students, and partially you'll be using shape, cocci, bacilli, spirilla, and configuration, diplo, which we can use for cocci or bacilli, diplococci, diplobacilli, and staphylo and strepto, which we only use for cocci, staphylococci or streptococci. The end.